For dirt dodger Dick Blackburn, life is a beach. But for Kim and Aggie, it's time to stop his house from going further down the pan. Dick daren't invite friends over to eat anymore, but the remains of dinner parties past still cover his crusty kitchen.
This is disgusting!
Oh, look
how thick this is. Oh, Lord above me.
But how on earth did it get into this state in the first place?
I suppose I was one of those 60s idealists who thought entirely wrongly that he could change the world in some way. As I've become more pessimistic, I've let things go somewhat.
Well, you may have given up, Dick, but the cleaners haven't, and Kim definitely still means business.
Do you know what I'm going to do with this?
I shudder to think.
I see. Bend over the toilet. We're going to take the water out of the loo with this. Bicycle pump.
Yes.
Right. In you go. Draw it up.
And put it in the bucket, yeah?
I'm going to put vinegar down here, my love. And I don't want the vinegar diluted with any of the water from the toilet. The stronger this vinegar is, the purer this is, the better chance we've got of getting all this muck off this loo. Honestly, you've never, ever cleaned it. Honestly, be honest, have you?
In my sort of half-hearted fashion, I have.
But you've been here 18 years, lovey, and I believe it is 18 years, not lovey. Now, I need two bottles about this size. Look, it's just the cheap white vinegar. Not wine vinegar, cheap white vinegar. Right, and in I go, my darling, look. I think it'll take about two bottles to get to the level the water would normally be at. I'll tell you already, the smell is vinegary rather than pooey. Oh, isn't it wonderful, isn't it wonderful? Oh, lovely jubbly. Now, so I'm going to take borax. Now, borax you can buy in any supermarket. I'm using it just to make a paste with the vinegar, OK? Now, round me. Now, I'm simply going to cut... Oh, my, this is wonderful. Coat it right round, you see. You will be surprised how much this'll take off. I always get excited when I see something that's been dirty for so long that one manages to clean up. It gives me a darn good feeling, that, you know. Oh, God, it smells better already. It's killed that horrible toilet smell. If you can use these, what I call harmless cleaners, I think it's rather nice, actually. It's totally soaking in with the vinegar. We leave it a few hours, though.
Meanwhile, Aggie is eager to reveal Dick's mummified taps.
OK, I've got a plastic scraper here. It's all quite sludgy and slimy.
Well, the miracle of vinegar, eh?
Right, Dick, I don't want to hog all the pleasure for myself, so there are other ways. Just dampen it and get to work.
Not that I'm, you know, actually showing any enthusiasm, but I've got to admit it works, yes.
As the grime warriors fight on, the results of Kim's toilet offensive are ready to be revealed.
Now, this is my big moment. I love this, you know. I do, honestly. Look, lovey. Now, I'm going to show you something. It is amazing. Look at this, my love. With the vinegar, it loosens it all, and that is so thick. I mean, it's like marbles. And that's years and years of calcium and God knows what.
I'm astonished that all that stuff was actually in my toilet.
Oh, there's more. I'll show you something. Look. Look. It's worked. Look at it. Look. It was chocolate brown. It's a flipping miracle, isn't it? Now, let's be honest.
Yeah.
Looking down, my God. Vinegar and borax. Cheap and cheerful.
Right, OK.
As the cleaners turn the corner, Aggie can't wait to lift the lid on the beasties Dick's been snoozing with.
That came out of your mattress.
Oh, 18 years worth, eh?
Well,
that's bits of me, basically,
isn't it? It's bits of you and millions upon millions of dust mites in that bed, pooing day and night, and their faeces are full of allergens, and I'm amazed that you're not coughing and spluttering from one end of the dish to the other.
I'm not.
It's a matter of time, let me tell you. And although it's sort of relatively clean now, I'm going to show you a little tip for getting the smelly bits out of it, OK? Here, in the flour sifter, I've got some bicarbonate of soda, OK? Do you want to do it, actually? Why don't you?
Just sprinkle the surface,
okay. that's right. And the thing about bicarbonate of soda is that it doesn't mask the smell and leave the smell underneath. It actually neutralises odour, so it works really well.
Oh, this is going to take absolutely ages, this.
It's hardly elbow grease you're using. So you just leave it for a few hours and then vacuum it off again. That will leave it sweet-smelling.
With the fight against filth on the home straight, Aggie wants to make sure Dick doesn't return to his bad old ways. The results are back from the lab.
You know that went around your house taking a few samples to send off to the lab? Those lucky boys.
Yes.
Well, I had a bit of a chuckle at your place, I can tell you. Now, this is from a spoon in your kitchen. There are traces here of Klebsiella. So we're talking fecal contamination on a spoon in your kitchen. Now, I'm not suggesting for a minute that you're not washing your hands after you've been to the loo. What may be happening is that because your loo is right next to the kitchen, you need to be closing the lid before you flush because the Klebsiella on the fecal particulates will aerosolise and be transferred into the kitchen. They can travel 6 feet easily. OK, now, this plate has salmonella on it and it's from your tin opener. Now, that's not a good thing to have on a tin opener. Is it salmonella?
I can understand that, yes. I'm defying the laws of medical science.
You are, actually. You absolutely are. This here is actually very serious. It's listeria.
Mm-hmm.
It's all over your kitchen. If somebody was pregnant, it could very likely lead to a stillbirth. OK, that doesn't affect you, but if you're cooking for someone who was in that position, then you would be putting them in danger.
Mm-hmm.
Hard words from Aggie, but the bugs have been sent scuttling as the cleaners apply their finishing touches. Time for Dick to see how things have scrubbed up.
Hello, Richard.
Hello there.
Good evening,
girls. Hi, Dick.
Do you want the good news or the bad news?
I'll start with the bad
news. Right, thank you. I'm going to show you something, and if it doesn't shock you, you're going to amaze me.
Go on, then.
This is the water that's come out of your carpet.
It's filth that's come out of my house.
That's right.
Yes.
870 litres of this grimy, horrible, stinky water.
Mm. Is that another record for me, is it?
Yes.
Hang on.
Get the record. I'm telling you, dear, you are the filthiest beggar
in the country.
It's been my misfortune to come across, but I'm a glutton for punishment.
You are incorrigible. You really are.
Get in this house before I kick you.
Come on.